In typewriter, you're a colon making its way through the history and evolution of literary text. You'll start from the vague origins of writing and come into the more familiar fonts of Times New Roman and Helvetica. Your abilities are to roll, jump, wall jump, and rotate, either controlled by buttons or the rear touchpad, which happens to work fine. As two dots, you'll naturally come off a bit slippery, and this adds a bit of sometimes unwelcome challenge to the straightforward platforming and puzzle solving. The main draw of Typewriter is that it explores the history of letters, and collecting asterisks provides you with fascinating trivia that tell of writing's origins and artisans. For the first half of the game, it begs the question, is Typewriter an experience that needs to be played, or is it better read? Levels are placed in chapters that highlight a font. Chapters are segmented into sections, often only requiring a simple puzzle to be solved in order to proceed. This way, the level design doesn't always feel like the pieces are working together as a coherent whole. There have also been times when frame rate dropped in spite of minimalistic visuals, and there is a technically questionable instance where the camera fails to give a fair view of the succeeding platforms. Thankfully, this 3R game's latter half picks up and demonstrates the potential for stages and obstacles inspired by letters in various fonts. Its chapters of Clarendon and Pixels in particular were neat surprises, proving that levels of text can articulate into gaming. This version of the game also sports speedruns where you can upload your scores to an online leaderboard and can be more compelling than playing some levels of the main chapters. Its minimalistic visuals do well to underscore its theme of fonts, but the game's shining aesthetic is its sound, creating ambient and meditative music perfect for reading. Typewriter gives a unique and fascinating look into the progression of text. It shows glimpses of eloquent platforming, but rather than call it a platformer with literary inspirations, it's a speedrun through the history of letters inspired by platforming elements.